Hello and welcome to Binge Buddies. In today's episode of Candid Conversation, we are speaking with Mr. Jaimini Pathak. You might know him as Rajat Khanna from TVF Pictures and most recently Sitaraman from Scam 1992. I'm really very excited to be speaking with him today. Before we proceed, do not forget to subscribe to Binge Buddies. Hello sir, good evening. Welcome to Binge Buddies.
Hi, good evening.
Thank you so much. For taking out the time this evening. I'm very excited to be speaking with you today.
Welcome. My pleasure.
So, with respect to your work, and I'm talking only on screen, you have been working for over 30 years now. We've seen your on-screen presence in film, which is Hazaro Khwahish Aisi, a film very close to my heart. I've seen you in OTT space. For me, my first experience of knowing who Mr. Jaimini Pathak is, was Rajat Khanna in TVF Pictures. Then I saw a web series of yours, which is Home on Old Balaji, High on MX Player, and of course, the legendary Sitaraman in Scam 1992. That is, no one is going to beat that for a long, long time. I'm going to dive in slightly in the past, and correct me if I'm wrong. So coming from a multicultural family, you spent majority of your childhood between Andhra Pradesh and Rajasthan, Ajmer, right?
Yeah.
Now, you were a very, very studious kind of a student across your childhood during your schooling days. And in fact, you used to be a rank holder. You used to be amongst top three rankers throughout. Now, do you recall your first exposure into the world of acting?
Well, school, like everyone else who starts in school. Mm-hmm. So my first moment on stage, I think, was in the first standard. My dad was posted in Tiruchirappalli in Tamil Nadu.
Okay.
So I must have been, I was born in Andhra, but I have no memories of Andhra.
Okay.
My first memories are of Campion School in Tiruchirappalli.
Okay.
And I'd been dressed up as a soldier.
Mm-hmm.
With big mustaches.
All right.
उस जमाने में वो ऐसी मूछ आती थी, अंदर एक वो मेटल की क्लिप रहती थी.
ओके.
एंड दे यूज्ड टू प्रेस इट ऑन टू योर सेप्टम. देयर वाज नो गम और एनीथिंग.
आहा.
एंड इट यूज्ड टू हर्ट लाइक हेल बिकॉज़ इट्स लाइक लिटरली प्रेसिंग डाउन ऑन योर सेप्टम.
या
एंड अनफॉर्चूनेटली दीज मुस्टैशेस आल्सो हैड अ हैबिट ऑफ फॉलिंग ऑफ बिकॉज़ दे वरंट काइंड ऑफ
फिट इन लाइक या
या दे वरंट स्टक ऑन और दे वरंट टाइड आइदर.
या
सो आई रिमेंबर my short little, some must have been a 1 minute thing where we were two soldiers were supposed to go say something and come off again.
Uh-huh.
And I remember my little piece being the hit of the evening's performance, the function, simply because every time I would open my mouth to say my lines, my mustache would fall off.
Oh my God.
And then I had to pick it up and put it back again. And then when I started speaking again, so it fell off some four or five times.
Okay.
And the audience loved the part that, forget the actual play that was supposed to happen. But isn't it so cute that this little first standard boy has his mustache falling off all the time when he's supposed to be a fearsome soldier? So ye thi meri entry stage pe. Wow. Uske baad school mein bahut sare natak kiye.
Uh-huh.
I went to a school, most of my schooling was done in Ajmer in Rajasthan.
Yeah.
And the school, in addition to academics and sports, also believed a lot in doing plays and cultural activities, even though it was a boys' school. So yeah. boys would double up as girls and things like that.
So
school se nikalne se pehle main kuch 18-20 natak kar chuka tha ki mujhe bahut shauk tha, mujhe bahut maza aata tha.
Wow.
Uske baad I went to St. Xavier's College, Bombay. I was in the hostel.
All right.
And there also it had a wonderful library with the names of plays and playwrights I'd never heard of in my entire life.
Yeah.
French the, Spanish the, American playwrights the, British the, Indian sare playwrights the in translation.
Yeah.
Translated into English and Hindi. And kyunki Bombay mein bahut vibrant intercollegiate scene bhi hai dramatics ka.
Yeah.
तो उसमें थोड़ा घुसा, बहुत सारी किताबें पढ़ी, फिर थोड़े वर्कशॉप्स किए. एंड बाय द टाइम आई वाज इन माय सेकंड ईयर इन कॉलेज, आई हैड ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड वर्किंग विद प्रोफेशनल थिएटर ग्रुप्स एंड सत्यदेव दुबे के साथ मैंने ज्वाइन किया था. और सेकंड ईयर कॉलेज में ही मुझे पृथ्वी थिएटर में और एनसीपीए में परफॉर्म करने का चांस मिल गया था ऑलरेडी.
वाओ दैट्स
ग्रेट. वहां से मेरी जर्नी फिर चालू हुई है. फिर थिएटर करता रहा काफी टाइम तक. देन टेलीविजन का बूम हैपेंड.
Yeah.
All the channels came. So I've done television for about 5-7 years also.
All right.
But I was also constantly doing theater.
That's fantastic. What amuses me is very rarely हमें सुनने में आता है कि एक बच्चा पढ़ाई में rank holder है और extracurricular में भी सबसे ऊपर है. And then you have that both interest and you're balancing it out. It must be surely lot of difficulty. Like you know. Having that interest and passion and also giving that amount of time for studying regularly to make sure you are in top three. And like you genuinely enjoyed studying or was it a parental pressure ki nahi aapko lana hai types?
Parental pressure to rehta hi hai. Matlab agar padhai mein bekar ho bachcha to bhi chinta hoti hai aur padhai mein achcha ho to bhi chinta hoti hai.
So that's Indian parents after all.
इंडियन पेरेंट्स के पढ़ाई में अच्छा है तो भाई फिर पढ़ लिख के कुछ बनो और पढ़ाई में बेकार हो तो पढ़ लिख के तो कुछ बनो के नहीं कुछ और ही कर लो. सो मेरे साथ वो था कि पढ़ लिख के तुम कुछ डॉक्टरी करो इंजीनियर बनो ऐसा कुछ मतलब एमबीए करो ये था. सो आई हैड टू फाइंड माय वे थ्रू दैट बिकॉज आई वाज इंटरेस्टेड इन बीइंग अ डॉक्टर और एन इंजीनियर. सो देन आई चेंज्ड माय स्ट्रीम आफ्टर 12th स्टैंडर्ड फ्रॉम साइंस एंड आई टुक अप इकोनॉमिक्स एंड स्टैटिस्टिक्स. फिर उसके बाद मैंने एक MBA भी किया जिसमें से मैंने 7-8 दिन में ड्रॉप आउट मार दिया था. Because by the time I was already doing theater, so I realized that either you can do an MBA and follow this line, or you can
do
theater and be an actor and do that.
वो टाइम आ गया था कि आपको चूज करने का डिसीजन लेना था कि अब इट्स हाई टाइम.
बड़े मतलब हो रहे थे सामने मेरे सामने चॉइसेस आ रही थी. I love doing theater and acting so much. कि मैं वो MBA छोड़ के भाग गया था. मेरे घर वालों को एक हफ्ते तक पता नहीं था मैं कहाँ था.
Oh wow! I am a Xavierite myself, and I absolutely relate when you say the huge library, and then the ocean of books and lot of literature being available at your hands reach for you to explore. Unfortunately, I did not make good use of it apart from academic stuff. But I have read this that you spent maximum of your free time in library than the canteen or foyer or other places apart from when you were practicing for your play.
Yari dosti to thi, bante hain college mein hi dost bante hain, school ke dost hote hain fir, but wo kabhi kabhar because people go in different directions. Lose touch. Ab to Facebook Instagram ki wajah se all people are united all over again because it's easy. You just have to put in a search and it will throw up all your friends. So I made some very close friends in college. उनके साथ एक्चुअली बना यूं कि उनके साथ थिएटर भी करता था तो वो दोस्ती दोनों तरफ चले.
नाइस नाइस.
सो इट वर्क्ड बोथ वेज एंड देन दे कंटिन्यू टू बी माय फ्रेंड्स. बट द लाइब्रेरी वाज इट वाज आई वाज हंग्री एनीवे फॉर एक्सपोजर फॉर एक्सपीरियंसेस फॉर नॉलेज. सो लाइब्रेरी में बैठ के बहुत मजा आता था और वहां पे किताबें भी मतलब जो किताबें मैं पढ़ता था वो बहुत कम लोग पढ़ते थे तो कोई लाइन नहीं लगती थी उनके. Plays and things like that.
Yeah.
So मैं एक कोना पकड़ लेता था या इशू करा लेता था किताब और हॉस्टल में बैठ के मैं पढ़ते रहता था.
That's amazing.
So that was wonderful that I got to read a lot about theater and a lot of plays in college because of the library.
Amazing. Thank you so much for sharing that. Now, after working around 10 years in theater space, you finally registered or you started your own theater group in August 1999 and what amuses me most is the title. The name of the theater group is Working Title. Now you must share the reason behind name of your theater group. Was it like really well thought of or was it vice versa?
Actually, we were in a strange position because a very close associate in the theater and a friend of mine and an extremely good, one of the best Indian playwrights around, Ramu Ramanathan, had given me a script saying, would you like to do this?
Right.
And because I'd been doing theater for about 9-10 years and Sanjana Kapoor had been watching my work and I was performing regularly at Prithvi Theater also. So that year, the focus of the Prithvi Theater Festival was original plays by Indian playwrights.
All right.
So Sanjana ne mujhe date de di thi ki tum theater festival ho raha hai hamara November mein usme perform karoge. To maine kaha haan. Aur phir humne rehearsal chalu kar di.
जी.
लेकिन डेट थी और नाटक था. नाटक का नाम था, एक्टर थे, लेकिन ग्रुप का नाम नहीं था और कुछ सूझ नहीं रहा था. समथिंग विच वुड कीप ऑल ऑफ अस हैप्पी. तो फिर हमने कहा कि फिलहाल वर्किंग टाइटल रख देते हैं. And then later on, when we think of a name that we like, we'll keep that name. But unfortunately or fortunately, the name has stuck. So it's become working title.
Thank you so much for sharing that. And now let's move on and discuss about the most loved character, which is Sita Raman from Scam 1992. Now, there are a couple of things before I jump on to question about your process or your method per se. Is it true that you prefer having your script with you before you go onto the sets?
It's always an advantage, especially if it's such a well-written script as Scam 1992.
Yeah.
So, sabke directors ke aur production houses ke apne apne tarike hote hain. Kuch log de dete hain aapko script.
Yeah.
Sometimes you get only the audition script. Then when the role is confirmed, if you ask for the entire script, they give you the entire script. Non-disclosure agreement bhi sign karate hain.
Yes.
So that's how. But if you get the script, it's an advantage because you can prepare yourself a little bit. Mm-hmm. Not to fix yourself into any kind of thing, but you get a lot of ideas simply by reading the context of the scenes, the context of the character, the entire story, where it fits in. And also because I direct plays also, so I like getting an overall picture of where a character is situated.
Yeah, yeah.
Uske life kya hai, uske aage peeche kya hai, uske log kya hai, kya wo story se kis tarah se connected hai.
Yeah.
ये सब एज एन एक्टर मुझे बहुत invaluable information लगती है, बहुत बढ़िया information लगती है.
Yeah.
उससे फिर ideas सोचते हैं, फिर वो मैं ideas स्टोर कर लेता हूँ, थोड़े ideas prepare कर लेता हूँ.
Okay.
फिर सेट पे जाके you try it out, the director says yes, this is good, go ahead. Uh-huh. That's how it happens. That's how it happened with Sita Raman also.
Fantastic. So if I am understanding correctly, you prefer preparing yourself as much as possible, getting into the right mindset, if not getting into the character per se, but aap is tarah us script ko padhte to understand uska agla pichla and kya uski life hai, and then you go on to the sets, which is like, yes, I'm ready, roll now.
Yeah, and whatever you is thrown at me, of course, everything is created on the set. This is just preparation. It's like the difference between batting at the in the nets and then batting in the match. So match to set pe khela jata hai.
Of course, yeah.
Jab action bolte hain to shuru hota hai match, aur cut bolte hain to phir wo over khatam hota hai.
Correct.
So it's like that.
Perfect. According to you, how important it is for an actor to improvise a scene?
It's very important actually. Kyunki aapko jo writing milti hai, that's a springboard. Mm-hmm. And a good writer will try to make the scene and the dialogue as real or authentic as possible.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But then when actors and the director get together on the set, uski bhi ek apni ek energy, uska ek apna magic hota hai interaction ka.
Yes.
So, aisa maine bahut kam dekha hai ke jo likha hai bilkul wahi ka wahi waisa ka waisa bolna hai. If you are doing Shakespeare or you're doing Bernard Shaw, ya aisa koi aap Sanskrit natak kar rahe hain, kuch kar rahe hain, to usme kyunki wo language in itself is such a so intrinsic to the to the performance, so then you stick to that. But otherwise a lot of improv comes in, as long as you're not drastically changing the meaning of the scene or the character or taking it off track from the story. Especially in cinema, I feel improv is also keeps the performances fresh. It keeps all the actors reacting. Many a time, even when I was doing Scam 1992, no two takes were the same. So even when you're going to the edit table, the editor has lots of options to play around with.
Right.
When they're doing the final cut. Ye wala reaction. Us take ka acha hai, lekin ye wala reaction. Kyunki picture to edit table pe banti hai finally.
True. Very true.
Decision liya jata hai ki kya kaun sa kitne. So 5-6 take mein se ya 3-4 take mein se, that's how it comes together. So in that sense, improv throws up a lot of options also.
Got it. It definitely helps the makers to then take a decision on the editing table. That's very...
Karte vakti maza aata hai. You're on your toes all the time.
Yeah, yeah.
All the actors are reacting in real time instead of just coming and saying their lines. Lines are not the performance.
Yeah, yeah.
Many a times the performance is between the lines, the silences, the way you're relating to your characters. Jaise Sita Raman ka bhi character hai, usme meri koi aisi lambi chaudi line hai nahi hai.
Haan.
Haan. इनफैक्ट द मोस्ट पॉपुलर लाइन जिसपे मतलब लोग अभी भी मुझे इंस्टाग्राम पे डीएम और मजाक करते रहते हैं वो इट इज ओनली 3 words बीआर है सर क्वेश्चन मार्क
टू आर वेरी ट्रू
but it's only the pauses and the silences yeah. before and after and the way the scene plays out and how that br is such a focus of my existence aur uski wajah se kaise bhanda phootta hai pure scam ka
yeah
a lot of world cinema thrives on silence agar aap iranian cinema dekhenge ya even if you look at a lot of european cinema it thrives on silence. What is unsaid? What is said? What is unsaid?
Gestures or just the expressions, aankhon se baat karna and all of these things. Yeah, absolutely. Now, when you were logged in for the part of Sita Raman, aap sab final ho gaya hai aur ab script aa gayi, aap ready hoke ja rahe hai. Do you recall? Aapko yaad hai ki what was the brief given by the director Hansal Mehta to you ki ye character aisa hai?
Actually, a lot of what. Happens in my performance apart from the fact that I worked on getting that authentic Tamil accent to my Hindi and English because I'd had the opportunity to spend a couple of weeks in Coimbatore about 2 years before I began shooting for Scam.
All right.
So I had gone to do a school project there.
Okay.
And the children there, and there was a particular teacher who was actually Punjabi and she used to interact a lot with me. तो उनकी हिंदी ग्रामेटिकली करेक्ट थी लेकिन वो जब बोलती थी तो सुनाई ऐसा देता था जैसे तमिल बोल रही है उनकी भाषा का लहजा
द फ्लो ऑफ इट या
लहजा उनका तमिल हो गया था हालांकि शब्द हिंदी थे तो फिर उसको मैंने रिकॉल किया माय कन्वर्सेशंस विद हर हाउ शी यूज्ड टू उसको प्रैक्टिस किया तो वो मैं प्रिपेयर करके गया था फिर मैंने डायरेक्टर साहब से पूछा कि ये मैं ट्राई करूं तो बोले अगर तुम कॉन्फिडेंट हो तो करो फिर उन्होंने बहुत सारे जैसे हमने कहा ना इम्प्रोव करते रहते थे तो छोटी 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 चीजें ही वुड कीप सजेस्टिंग टू ऑल द एक्टर्स इंक्लूडिंग मी
ओके
कि लेट्स ट्राई दिस लेट्स ट्राई दैट ही द नाइस थिंग अबाउट वर्किंग विद हंसल मेहता इज दैट ही नेवर एवर सेड एटलीस्ट व्हेन आई वाज शूटिंग दिस इज एग्जैक्टली हाउ आई वांट द सीन दिस इज व्हाट आई हैव इन माइंड
गॉट इट
मुझे ऐसा सीन तो नहीं तो क्या होता है आपको एक गोल पोस्ट दिखा दिया जाता है और आपको फिर वहां तक पहुंचने की कभी कभार एंजाइटी हो सकती है एज एन एक्टर वेयर एज ही हैज हिज स्टाइल ऑफ फंक्शनिंग इज काइंड ऑफ जस्ट काइंड ऑफ कीपिंग थिंग्स गोइंग कीपिंग थिंग्स अलाइव गिविंग सजेशंस कॉन्स्टेंटली ट्राइंग थिंग्स आउट इम्प्रूविंग
Amazing. So it's a two-way conversation जहां सबका इनपुट मैटर करता है एंड देन वी विल वर्क आउट व्हाट वर्क्स कलेक्टिवली बेस्ट फॉर द सीन
हाँ और वो बड़े अनऑब्ट्रूसिव तरीके से बीच में आके छोटा सा एक सजेशन दे देंगे मुझे दे देंगे मेरे को एक्टर को दे देंगे नो नेगेटिविटी
ऑलराइट या या
रिहर्सल में भी वही तो हम पहले रिहर्स करते थे सीन्स को रिहर्स करने के बाद पर नन ऑफ द रिहर्सल्स और द टेक्स वर एग्जैक्टली द सेम एवर व्हिच इज अ वेरी नाइस वे ऑफ डूइंग सिनेमा समटाइम्स यू हैव टू नेल द सीन एग्जैक्टली द सेम वे एवरी सिंगल टाइम But here there was a lot of freedom in that sense. You were very free as an actor. You didn't have to aim for a frame, be a light somewhere. But the DOP also, Pratham Mehta, was very actor friendly in the way he was shooting.
Yeah.
So that gives you the freedom to move, to do a little bit of improvisation.
Yeah.
कहीं मैं हल्का मैंने आधा फुट इधर चला गया या कुछ मुझे इंपल्स आई तो मैं आउट ऑफ फ्रेम तो नहीं हो गया.
Exactly.
या मैंने पूरी कॉम्पोजिशन तो नहीं बिगाड़ दी.
Yeah.
ये सारी चीजें भी बड़ी बड़ी हेल्पफुल होती हैं बड़ी मायने रखती हैं
वेरी ट्रू
तो इफ यू आर अ सेंसिटिव एक्टर यू स्टार्ट रिएक्टिंग टू थिंग्स अराउंड यू
या
एंड दे स्टार्ट यू स्टार्ट काइंड ऑफ एसिमिलेटिंग देम इनटू योर परफॉर्मेंस
करेक्ट
तो ओवरऑल टीम वर्क ऑफ स्कैम 1992 इज एब्सोल्युटली एक्सेप्शनल इन दैट सेंस
अनडाउटेडली
एवरीथिंग वाज गियर्ड टुवर्ड्स ब्रिंगिंग आउट द मोस्ट ऑथेंटिक काइंड ऑफ portrayal of the series
definitely it shows up and the kind of love it has received and it's still receiving is unbelievable and definitely it's one of the best Indian web series for sure and for a longer time I don't see anything breaking that record in the near future but it has raised the bar to another level for sure that's great and one last thing with respect to Scam 1992 as an actor as a director yourself How was your experience interacting and acting alongside Prateek Gandhi?
Actually, Prateek and I have worked together twice before this.
Okay.
And he's a wonderful actor and a wonderful co-actor and a really nice guy. तो हमने एक थिएटर परफॉर्मेंस किया था, हालांकि it was an evening of poems in Gujarati.
Okay.
So he was performing his poem and I was performing my own poem, but we had interacted before that.
Got it.
And he had seen me in pictures, so he had come up to me and said, really liked your performance. And also, we were already kind of, I didn't know who he was. बाद में पता चला कि he's a very big star in Gujarati.
Ah, okay.
जैसे we started rehearsing.
हाँ.
Then we did a Gujarati film called Dhunki,
yeah,
about a year and a half, 2 years ago.
Yeah.
So that was where we had already worked together. Then we kept interacting theater mein because he also does theater, I also do theater. So hamari mulaqat hoti rehti thi. And then we got this chance of working together again. So it's always a pleasure to work with him. It's saath kaam kiya hua hai aur kaam karne mein bhi is baar bhi bahut maza aaya.
What I personally liked throughout your part as Sitaraman is there was so much in your eyes. Like, you know, there were moments of silence. There was that constant fear of getting caught, of you've done something out of trust because you've seen the past and everything. But there is always that fear in your character's mind ki, oh, main pakda jaunga. Ye mere pe aa jayega. I will be one who is blamed. And then eventually once you lose your mind and that anger in that eyes in that scene, it shows how much that BR means to you. That BR is like literally jaan se zyada zaruri hai us waqt aapke liye. And that is fabulous. It has come across so well.
Again, it goes back probably, I don't want to say 2+2=4, but aapne shuru mein pucha tha ki agar aapko puri script mil jati hai, to isse farak padta hai kya? Yeah. To jab mujhe pata chala the situation that my character is in,
yeah. Yeah.
And also the point at which the character is arriving.
Yeah.
And how the character is being affected by the story before. And how the character is affecting the story that is now unfolding.
Right.
So iski agar halki si awareness ho to shayad wo aapke performance mein percolate ho jati hai.
Haan.
Usme aap uska, kyunki aap ye cheeze consciously zyada karne jayenge to mehnat dikhne lagti hai.
Haan. True.
Aur phir उसको सहजता से करना और आजू बाजू वाले लोग भी सहजता से उसे निकलवा लें, डायरेक्टर उसे सहजता से निकलवा लें आपसे. मुझे याद है पहला दिन मेरा शूटिंग का था और नर्वस तो था ही. आप कितना भी काम कर लो वो नर्वसनेस जाती नहीं और वो अच्छी बात है. नर्वसनेस मींस दैट यू वांट टू डू वेल, यू आर टेकिंग योर जॉब सीरियसली. सो एवरी एक्टर हुज पैशनेट अबाउट हिज और हर वर्क इज नर्वस. तो प्रोबेबली आई वाज ट्राइंग टू डू टू मच.
Mm-hmm.
तो हंसल ने मुझसे कहा कि रिलैक्स, इतना करने की जरूरत नहीं है. जस्ट बी द कैरेक्टर, डोंट ट्राई टू प्रोजेक्ट टू मच.
ओके.
तो पहले दिन उन्होंने जस्ट इन अ 30 और 40 सेकंड कॉन्वर्सेशन उन्होंने मुझे एक तरह से ही गेव मी अ थ्रू थ्रेड टू माय कैरेक्टर. सो व्हेन यू आर सेइंग दैट इट इज सटल और व्हेन इट इज सिंग, देन आई हेल्ड ऑन टू दैट एंड आई कुड प्ले विद द साइलेंसेस. I never felt that I have to take the scene forward. कि अरे कुछ हो नहीं रहा है.
हाँ,
ये बड़े मतलब मैं गहराई में बातें कर रहा हूँ. पता नहीं इसका कुछ
शायद बहुत ज़्यादा
audience को कुछ महत्व हो या नहीं हो.
मैं वही बोलने वाला था कि होंगे बहुत सारे लोग होंगे जो इन nuances को भी ध्यान ना दें. उनका शायद ध्यान जाए ही ना कि अरे ये क्या था. वो उसको एक पॉज की तरह नोटिस करें. I really am fascinated by the way certain artists do this. Like I personally feel silence and eyes ke through wahi emotion convey karna is way, way more challenging than to speak out a dialogue and convey an emotion.
Camera bhi aapki madad karta na bahut kuch.
Ha.
Agar aap khud ko reveal karne ke liye ready hai to phir to camera aapko soak lega. It will absorb.
Great. Thank you so much for that. Do you have any thoughts of directing your own feature film?
I prefer being an actor in cinema because I land up. I'm a selfish being. I only have to deliver my job. I'm the captain of my ship and I have to be a good sailor on the ship with the director and with my co-actors. And I enjoy that connection. But being the overall boss of 200 people and seeing a film through a year and a half, 6 months of shooting or a series, स्कैम इज ऑलमोस्ट 9.5-10 hours ऑफ कॉन्टेंट. उसको उन्होंने 2.5 साल तक लिखा है. इतना आप में मतलब दम चाहिए टू सी फाइव साइमल्टेनियस ड्रीम्स लाइक दिस एंड स्क्रिप्ट्स थ्रू इन द होप ऑफ ऑल ऑफ देम और वन ऑफ देम और थ्री ऑफ देम विल गेट मेड. Maybe my framework where cinema is concerned is one of being an actor and enjoying myself and and showing the variety that I have as an actor.
I read that Nidhi Bisht, who is also a part of TVF family, then came up to you hitchkichate hue aapse pucha ki kya ek aisa aisa show bana rahe hain hamari team, kya aap aake audition dena chahenge? Is that true?
Kyunki I think TVF had been around for a couple of years. And मुझे उस वक्त कुछ ऑनलाइन कॉन्टेंट देखने का कुछ शौक था नहीं. It was all very new in India. There was no Netflix or any streaming platforms. There was just YouTube. तो मुझे कुछ पता नहीं था. तो उसने कहा था कि मैं ऐसी मेरी कम and I knew कि she used to regularly before rehearsal after rehearsal keep going to this bunch of people and she was working on stuff. तो मैंने कहा हाँ अच्छी बात है कि अब तक I was giving you work, अब तो मुझे काम दे रही हो तो ये तो बड़ा natural सा extension है, why not? So then they called me to the office. मुझे सीन पहले दे दिया था. तो मैं in my typical fashion, मैं थोड़ा अच्छा लिखा हुआ सीन था, बहुत विश्वपति सरकार ने बहुत अच्छा सीन लिखा था. गया मैं, निधि ने एक दो बार ऐसी मेरे साथ रिहर्सल की. Then the director अमित गुलानी also came, watched the rehearsal, watch one audition if you want to call it that. And then he said, "Bas ab isko idhar chhod dijiye, isko ab zyada views mat kijiye." So I think he also wanted. So he had made up his mind that this is the actor I want, and probably in the same way as Hansal, he wanted to keep it fresh and kind of in a reactive sort of a space. और फिर उसके कुछ दिनों बाद हमने जाके shoot किया, and the scene turned out to be what it a double camera setup था. और हमने दो तीन बार सीन को रोल किया, थोड़ा चेंज किया, एंड एवरीवन वाज वेरी हैप्पी विद द वे इट वेंट. इंसिडेंटली मुझे सिर्फ वो एक सीन करना था एक्चुअली पिक्चर्स में. लेकिन वो सीन इतना पॉपुलर हो गया कि फिर उन्होंने दे रोट मी इनटू एपिसोड 4 अगेन, बिकॉज़ आई थिंक द डायरेक्टर एंड द टीम एंड द राइटर मस्ट हैव डिसाइडेड दैट वी सीम टू हैव फाउंड अ नाइस एंटागोनिस्ट इन द स्टोरी. So then I was written in, and then they called me back to shoot for episode 4.
And these were the days we are talking jab ek to web series ka culture nahi tha, to ye aise tha ki writing bhi ho rahi hai, shoot bhi ho raha hai, and simultaneously lot of things were happening, especially with pictures.
Audience response as you're going along. Aajkal to aap puri script likh ke aapko submit karni padti hai, fir wo OTT usko haan bolta hai, lekin ye log khud hi producer the, khud hi OTT the, khud hi sab kuch the, so they had that freedom at that point in time.
Right.
To gauge audience response.
Exactly.
So it was all very much in its elementary stage in that sense.
And somehow that worked. And it's not just because it is a luck factor or anything. It actually worked because of the content, the purity of it, the way it was written, and of course, the way it was performed. Now, I will never, never forget the way Rajat Khanna stands up to Naveen Kasturia and says, "Is देश का youth जब अपने 9 to 5 के job से bore हो जाता है, तो उसके सामने सिर्फ तीन option उसे दिखते हैं." And the way you give it is like, हाँ मैं आपको advice दे रहा हूँ. I definitely don't want you to leave my employment and go and do whatever you are planning to. But you're also trying to scare him, giving him a reality check. And the way sarcasm, I felt it, correct me if that was not the case, but the way sarcasm is given in a slap, ki ye reality hai, get a check for yourself. Was that intentional? As you mentioned, script aapko mil gayi thi. So when you prepared yourself, was that your mindset ki is tarah se hi aapko dena hai?
See, agar ek achha likha hua scene ho, to main kya karta hu, usko roughly I try to break it up into the how the scene is flowing. Kyunki बात हमेशा goes from a certain point to another point to another point to another point to finally the last, the end of the scene. But it's not just what is being said. Overall, the scene is also saying something.
Correct.
है ना? आप उसको एक ही लेवल पे भले प्ले कर रहे हो, लेकिन ओवरऑल एक कहानी भी कही जा रही है.
Correct. Absolutely.
तो उसकी मैं एक I try to keep that kind of an awareness that in addition to what my performance is, what my character is, what my relationship is, can I with my co-actor or co-actors kind of elevate the whole scene to a level where, like you said, एक statement बनाया जा रहा है लेकिन उसको slip in कर दिया है. और उसके फिर वो memes भी बने बहुत सारे, और वो अभी भी वो line आपको याद है, मुझे याद है.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल बिल्कुल. वो and of course it's a good writing, but हमारे ज़हन में अक्सर वो चेहरा और the way it is delivered वो ज़्यादातर रहता है, as a, it's the whole visual memory thing. And तो
वो
अभी नहीं
जब चल रहा था सीन, सीन का वो ऐसा हो रहा था कि वो मैंने वो जेस्चर एक्चुअली डिसाइड नहीं किया था.
That's what I'm trying to understand कि आपका जो बॉडी फील में आ गया, not very well.
उस वक्त जैसे आप रिएक्ट कर रहे हैं, that is actually when you are in the moment, what is happening is the most important thing. Everything that you have prepared is just net practice.
क्या बात है?
So it is these moments of magic or spontaneity or being in this, immersed in the scene, which throws up a surprise for you as an actor, and you go with that instinct. और वो इंस्टिंक्ट वर्क कर जाता है आपके को-एक्टर के लिए भी, सीन के फ्लो में भी.
So आपको स्क्रिप्ट मिली and as you mentioned कि लिखा गया था सिर्फ एक एपिसोड के लिए, but the way it was loved by audience, they thought कि ये कैरेक्टर को और थोड़ा सीन्स देते हैं, इसका पार्ट बढ़ाते हैं. So did you happen to see the end product, which is the episode yourself before going for filming of the next episode? Did you see it first? And second, did you happen to gauge ki okay ab do you want to take it a level upar iske aage? What was your thought?
Situation alag hai, lekin mera character wahi hai. Mera relationship with Naveen is already defined in the first episode.
Haan.
So there is already ek kaata hai hamare beech mein, there is
right.
A bit of a
right,
aur usko kis tarah se ab is episode mein resolve main apne tarike se karne ki koshish karta hu aur wo apne tarike se resolve kare. तो वो कॉन्फ्लिक्ट तो ऑलरेडी एग्जिस्टिंग है, अब उसको नए लेवल पे लिया जा रहा है, द स्टेक्स आर मच हायर. उस वक्त तो इट वाज ओनली हिम, नाउ इट इज हिज ड्रीम.
हां,
एंड देयर आर थ्री अदर पीपल इन्वॉल्व विद हिम, एंड इट्स अ ह्यूज ह्यूज ओकेजन. और साथ में वो रियल टाइम स्टार्टअप फाउंडर्स भी बैठे थे, दे वर नॉट एक्टर्स, दे वर द एक्चुअल फाउंडर्स.
यस 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 यस, ग्रेट, थैंक यू फॉर दैट. व्हाट वन पीस ऑफ एडवाइस वुड यू लाइक टू गिव एज एन एक्टर एंड डायरेक्टर for these people who want to become a writer or director now?
Inform yourself about what the demands of your chosen specialization or, or whatever passion is.
Mm-hmm.
Passion can get you only 3-4, may max 10 years into the line, but it's not just a passion, it's a profession, it's an art and a craft.
Mm-hmm.
Learn, sign up for classes with good people,
yeah.
Be hungry, इन्फॉर्म. डोंट, सिनेमा तो इतना क्रूअल है कि लोग सिर्फ उसका एंड प्रोडक्ट देख के उनको लगता है कि अरे यार मतलब दुनिया वैसी है. इसीलिए a lot of people who come actually to see a film shoot get terribly bored.
Yeah.
You can't only see the end product. It's a very painstaking journey.
Yeah.
Many a time only the light at the end of the tunnel is what keeps you going.
That is true.
कि ये मुझे वहां तक पहुंचाना है, लेकिन उसमें बहुत सारे हजारों इंटरमीडिएट स्टेप्स आते हैं.
Right.
So just get real about the actual demands. अगर आप इंजीनियर बनना चाहते हैं तो आपको 5 साल या 4 साल तो करना ही पड़ता है. डॉक्टरी में तो 6-8 साल लग जाते हैं. So inform yourself well and get into the nitty-gritty of what the demands of the profession are.
True. Very, very well said. Thank you so much for that valuable piece of advice. Let's play a quick rapid fire game.
Yeah, well, I might be bad at this, but let's
nothing difficult, don't worry about it. Which was the latest movie you saw, the most recent movie you saw, Hindi and English?
Ludo, I think. Ludo. And Love Is Not Enough. So AK versus AK dekhi, fir meri purani favorites hai, I keep revisiting them. To kabhi man kare inspire hone ka to Godfather dekhne lagta hu. उसमें सारे एक्टर भरे पड़े हैं.
यस,
एक्ट्रेसेस, एक्टर सब भरे पड़े हैं.
या, व्हिच वाज द मोस्ट रिसेंटली यू सॉ अ हिंदी एंड इंग्लिश सीरीज?
आई हैव बीन एक्चुअली वाचिंग अ फ्रेंच सीरीज कॉल्ड कॉल माय एजेंट.
आहा,
व्हिच इज नेटफ्लिक्स, उसके इंग्लिश सबटाइटल्स आते हैं. तो 3 सीजन मैंने बिंज वॉच मार दिए थे बिकॉज समबडी रिकमेंडेड टू मी, और अभी उसका 4th season हैज जस्ट रिलीज्ड.
Uh-huh.
And it's about the French casting. It's about a casting agency based in Paris.
Yes, yes.
And how hard they work there to pitch their actors.
Yeah.
And in French, the series is called 10%, just for 10% of the actors. So it's a wonderful, wonderful insight into the workings of the French film industry.
Yeah.
And the industry in general.
Yeah.
And the nice thing is that they take actual stars in each episode.
Ha. I was about to mention that.
And they work. So one episode is dedicated to one star and his or her challenges and problems and whatever.
Add three things on top of your mind which you think changed after Scam 1992 for yourself.
Well, for me personally, it's a confidence. Because it had been a long layoff because of the lockdown and whatever, and everyone was just wondering. So when the series received such an amazing response that none of us were prepared for.
Yeah.
So it felt great as an artist that your work and everyone's collective effort was appreciated.
Yes.
So ye bahut achha laga mujhe. Dusra ke people have actually noticed the quality of my performance. And liked it and said, wonderful acting.
Yes.
So wo ek bahut acha validation lagta hai ke people saw the character and they saw the actor behind the character.
Yeah.
So wo acha lagta hai ke bhai maine jo bhi maine koshish ki maine consciously unconsciously apne co-actor director writer ke saath wo logon tak main pahuncha paya usse logon ne appreciate kiya.
Ji.
और तीसरा है कि उसकी वजह से पीपल आर ऑल्सो ऑफरिंग मी वेरी अदर वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग रोल्स इन अदर प्लेटफॉर्म्स जैसे ये फिल्म मुझे मिली देन आई एम ऑल्सो गोइंग टू स्टार्ट शूटिंग एंड आई हैव शॉट फॉर सम अदर वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग प्रोजेक्ट्स एंड नन ऑफ देम आर आस्किंग मी टू प्ले द सेम काइंड ऑफ कैरेक्टर दे आर नॉट कॉलिंग मी टू कम एंड प्ले सीतारमण
राइट
फॉर एग्जाम्पल
That's
the have somewhere they have recognized that ye acha actor hai isse hum ye bhi karwa sakte hain chalo to audition mein main janbujh ke I try to create a new authentic character every time instead of trying to reproduce what I have already done
that is
so, which is an interesting journey to be on
thank you for sharing that can you give order of preference for yourself for the following all right A is theater movies and series what is your order of preference
all of them are wonderful in their own way there is no preference here theater ka live experience hai theater ka craft alag hai to uska thrill alag hai cinema ka agar aap bade screen pe dekh rahe hain to just the experience of watching something on the big screen it is a whole experience in itself so as an actor all three are mediums that I'm very happy and eager to explore all the time right now this excites me the online space excites me simply because of the content that is being explored ke aap jo cheez shayad 2 ghante mein ek cinema hall mein nahi dikha sakte hain ya stage pe aap nahi dikha sakte wo aap aaram se ek character ki parte khol ke kahani ki parte khol ke aap usko audience tak pahuncha sakte hain aur audience dekhne ko taiyar hai Yes. ऑडियंस का भी व्यूइंग हैबिट्स हैव चेंज दिमाग खुल गया है दे आर वाचिंग वर्ल्ड क्लास कंटेंट
या एंड इट हैज ओपनड अप अ लॉट ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटीज प्लस इंक्लूडिंग हंगर फॉर मोर बेटर एंड बेटर कंटेंट डे बाय डे व्हिच वर्क्स बोथ वेज देन फैंटास्टिक एंड इफ यू कुड प्लीज एज एन इंडिविजुअल ऑर्डर ऑफ प्रेफरेंस में व्हाट वुड यू प्रेफर एक्टिंग राइटिंग डायरेक्टिंग
at different points in time different things acting kar raha hu so I would prefer not to direct and write agar directing kar raha hu to I would prefer not I could write and direct okay. so theater mein kiya hai maine
okay
aur kai baar theater mein direct aur act bhi kiya hai but ideally I would like to separate all three and enjoy them
individually
to the fullest
amazing so that was the game thank you so much for sharing out your thoughts is there any upcoming projects like you mentioned you did a film with the John Abraham Productions Attack apart from that is there anything coming up where we can see you next officially which you can share
I don't know if I'm at liberty to speak about any of that
okay fair enough
wo, abhi shoot hona chalu hai
okay
jiska shoot ho chuka hai aur jiski already publicity ho chuki hai uske bare mein bataya maine attack ke bare mein
we wish you all the very best for all the upcoming projects and thank you so very much for taking out the time this evening it was a pleasure speaking with you
you're welcome maza aaya
bye
good luck bye
thank you so much for watching I really hope you enjoyed this conversation if you did do not forget to share it with your friends and family and subscribe to binge buddies for more such candid conversations. See you next time.